Hey, everybody. Alrighty, we're back here at one of our campsites. This is about 2 years old now. So these hemlock shelters, when they first were made, they were amazing green. But now they're ready to come down, so we're going to be clearing these out, using them as firewood tonight. Although hemlock pops like crazy at night, we won't be getting too close with any synthetic fibers. But we're going to be clearing these out and setting up our ridge lines here. These guys served us very well. We've had amazing nights in these primitive shelters. Just in these primitive shelters, under light rain, not torrential downpour, but we had them packed up with hemlock boughs up to about here. And so it was a massive protection. They served us well for about 2 years. And it's now about time to take them down. They're basically on a tripod with an elongated leg, and then boughs that are laced in between and thatched in all the way throughout. This has been my, in this area, has been my go-to shelter. We just lift it up, even with these branches, just throw a tarp over, and it's just such an awesome shelter to be under. But now I think it's time to let it go. As you can see, we got these tied up, and we're cutting those down. We're working on this, get this situated. All right.
Start cleaning that bad boy up. was too fast. Too fast. They hurry up. They hurry up and build a forest fire with their ferro rod. Safety. Oh, it's still alive. There we go. It's still alive. It's breathing. Did you make a raft under there? There you go. It's still alive. It died. Okay. Right, she's ready to try again. Do you have a proper bundle? That does not look proper. That's a proper bundle, okay. Nice, very good. All right, don't use the blade side. Okay, very nice. Right down on there, let's see. Okay, you have a raft going on. Okay. Breathe, let it breathe, let it breathe. Don't just drop it on there. Gotta let it breathe. Okay. Alright, let it come through, let it come through. Let it eat, let it eat. Very nice. Now once it passes through the top layer, let it eat, let it eat. Very nice. Okay, X fashion, cross fashion. Nice and light, nice and light. Let it breathe, let it eat. Very nice. That's a super great fire, Amma. And a super cute hat. Okay, nice and slow, nice and slow. Nice and slow. Okay. Alrighty, and now keep packing stuff on. Let it eat. Wanna let it eat? Let it breathe. Very nice. Nice job. Nice job, beautiful lady. Alrighty, I have a modified wheeling today. I have this flap just tucked over the top so that it doesn't drape over. I have this thing I got from Hobby Lobby that my wife really loves, so I can turn on a romantic candle in the wilderness with the cute bird that she loves, beeswax candle. It is on a prusik loop. It's giving tension on the ridge here. And just got my bleep can over there. Same setup, got my MMS, flap down, diamond style. But this time I have it not staked out. One corner is underneath, and I have it staked out on the second corner. This will give me more protection on this side, and also same on this side, as you can see. Much wider here than last time. So this is a modified wheeling. They're yanked up in the back and have a Taj Mahal inside with a lot of room, a lot of space. And I'm very far. Today, I don't know if I'm gonna make a fire today, probably not. We have already a fire going on over there, which she started over there. So we'll use that as the main fire and I'll just relax under the stars today. But that's the shelter today.
Have a lot of space to sit up in here in this modified Wayland have a lot of space to lay down, plenty of protection. We've got a beautiful hemlock forest in front of us. Right now it's just gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Breathe in, breathe out, thank you. Yeah, so it's pretty cool. Now I'll turn that on at nighttime. So I have a nice ambient light right around my shelter. And yeah, that's the Wayland. It's pretty good, it feels pretty good in here. But adequate coverage. It's not gonna rain tonight, so I don't have this really draped down. So I'll have a nice massive view. I'll show you the view.
Just pull this off the tripod real quick. Let's move the tripod so it doesn't get in the way of the view. Let's hide that over there. Okay, so here we go. And let's come inside. As you can see, there's a massive amount of space. And lay back. And as you can see, this gorgeous view is going to be tonight's view with the beautiful beeswax lantern. And this absolutely gorgeous view here. Okay, beautiful forest. Fantastic. Look at these mushrooms. There's a hardwood. I don't know what that is, what mushroom that is. Anybody in the bushcraft community, tell me what that is. We'd be very grateful. Look at these big ones down here. And it is on some type of hardwood tree. You can't really see up there. It's mixing in with the hemlock. But it is beautiful, isn't it? Oh, it's beautiful. Oh. There you go. Okay. Okay. Here's some. Here we go. Now it's focusing. There's some hemlock. Not the poisonous plant, but hemlock coniferous. Conifer. It's got a, here you can see the two white stripes underneath it. Oh, come on. Come on, two white stripes on each of the pines. And that's very nice. It's a little more subtle than the white pine. There's a white pine over here. And this is very, of course, very tasty. More potent. Her needles longer than hemlock. Very nice boost of vitamin C also. You can see down here, all sorts of wintergreen. Right here. I always like to test the leaf for the fragrance. Very wintry. Wintry. Very wintry. Minty fresh, fresh into the mouth with the pine. Of course, as you know, the wintergreen has the active ingredient of aspirin. So the native peoples used to use this to in decoctions to reduce fever over the daytime or over a period of time with multiple doses. But very good medicinals right in this area. Oh, good. All right, there's a candle there. And all right, nice. And check out the top of the shelter. Yes, and then the middle and inside. Very nice. All right. Beautiful. Thank you. Beautiful. Gorgeous. Very romantic, isn't it? All right, we got an emergency rain. All of a sudden, it started raining. Like real quick shower. I don't know if you can see that. It didn't actually penetrate through the hemlock forest. There was a big shower and then it passed right over. And now it's almost not raining anymore. Everybody was under panic mode to get under their shelters. good habits. Good habits last a lifetime. All right, looks like we're all right. All righty, check it out. This is a Asian fish stew with radish and different pieces of fish, and we're having it in the kuksa near the camp. It's raining too, it's raining, but it's good. Alrighty. Okay, finished with our soup and cleaning and finishing off the bowl, the kuksa, with green tea. This is actually how traditionally monks use green tea, actually, to because it's astringent, to clean their bowls after use the same rice bowl, and then use the green tea to clean it out. And so I just use this as a fish bowl, fish soup bowl, and after the soup, put a nice green tea that which will absorb the most of the oils, and of course fill me with nutrients. Just enjoy this under the pitter-pattering of the light, very light rain. All the kids are practicing thermoregulating and protecting their bodies from the rain and the ponchos. Again, he's building good habits. Alrighty. Ooh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Here comes that pork, Korean pork belly. Ooh, my, my, my. Goodness, goodness, goodness. Sizzling away. Morning now. Here the glorious fire. Ooh, very warm. Super, super warm. It is now 5:40. Most of the kids have gotten up. Got a nice morning service. And just warming up near the fire. Had a rough night because the back was not straight and the ground wasn't level. So woke up and pulled my back a little bit while picking up these logs. But it's now warmed up a little bit and the back feels a lot better. So, anyways, had a great night. Even though I didn't sleep super well, because you're outside breathing in that fresh air, that healing medicine. Fresh pot of hot water. Getting on the boil.